Hello everybody, welcome to my presentation. My name is Yunus Al-Kharousi from Communication and Information Research Center. I'm going to talk about the connectivity and cloud automation technologies for Internet of Things. Actually, it's a survey on main components. In this presentation, I'm going to talk about IoT in general, connectivity technologies, including Bluetooth, Zigbee, NFC, Thread, Wi-Fi, LoRaWAN. Then I'll talk about container and Docker. Then finally, I'll conclude my presentation. Internet of Things, it's based on our IoT. It's based on Internet of Things, which is a paradigm of network devices or things. Internet of Things, actually, it combines of three main parts, which are things, communication, and cloud. Things like sensors and actuators. Regarding to communication, there are two main parts, short range and long range. For cloud, there are virtualization, operating system, big data, analysis, and so on. Going deeply in some technologies or some connectivity technologies, first we'll start with Bluetooth, Bluetooth and BLE. Bluetooth, which is a wireless technology, used to transfer data in very short range. It operates on 2.4 gigahertz frequency band. Actually, it's predicted over 10 billion Bluetooth-enabled devices will be available on market in 2018. The application that could be used using Bluetooth is machine-to-machine and wireless personal area network. BLE, or Bluetooth Low Energy, or Smart Bluetooth, was available on market in 2011 as Bluetooth 4.0 version. This version of Bluetooth is specially introduced for some IoT needs. It also operates on 2.4 gigahertz frequency band. The significant difference between them is in power consumption. The Bluetooth actually consume power around 1 watt, but BLE from 1 to 3 milliwatts. And also, BLE can support many devices, so it's the ideal solution for personal area networks. The data rate for Bluetooth, it might reach up to 3 megabits per second. And for BLE, around 1 megabit per second. For Zigbee, it's based on IEEE 802.15.4 standard. Zigbee is using mesh network protocol, and it uses 2.4 gigahertz frequency band. Actually, this one is designed to carry small amount of data in short to medium distance. The maximum distance can reach is 250 meter. Zigbee has some limitations. These limitations is regarding to network latency and high density nodes, and also for mobility. NFC stands for near field communication. It's actually a great solution for IoT, is a fuse, low cost and low energy. It's an ideal for smart home applications because of easy of connect, commission, control. Regarding to connecting, it can the user can pair with other communication technology, and it's helpful for devices that have no interface, like sensors, light bulbs, and small appliances. Regarding to commission, it's easy to install the setup and logging data, and give the user ability to maintain the network. For control, it provides higher degree of flexibility and security. Control over and give the user control over settings and access privileges. NFC is operates on 13.56 megahertz, and the speed or the data rate is around 400 kilobit per second, with a maximum coverage range of 20 centimeter. Wi-Fi IEEE 802.11ah. This standard is proposed to meet IoT low power application requirements, because the previous standards like A, B, G, N, and AC are not suitable because of the high power consumption. The coverage of this standard may reach up to 1 kilometer, and it can connect up to 8,191 devices. It operates on unlicensed sub-gigahertz, and it has the ability to coexist with 802.15.4 standard like ZigBee and also Thread. Thread is a new standard or a new technology which is developed specially to support IoT applications. In 2015, it was the first released version, and it's also based on IEEE 802.15.4. This technology has the ability, or it supports IP version 6, and it can connect up to 250 devices using mesh network. It operates on 2.4 gigahertz with a maximum 250 kilobits per second data rate. The last technology that I'll present is the LoRaWAN, which is used in wider IoT application or projects like smart cities or smart grid. It's an ideal solution for industrial IoT application which wants to control sensors from a long distances. LoRaWAN is using mesh techniques to extend the coverage. The coverage may reach hundreds of square kilometers. Regarding to containers, containers let you run a Linux system within another Linux system. A container is a group of processes on Linux machine. Those processes form an isolated environment. Inside the container, it looks like a virtual machine, but outside the container, it looks like a normal process running on the machine. Actually, it looks like a virtual machine, but it is more efficient. Containers are lightweight virtualization. Containers, they are lightweight. On typical physical server with average compute resources, you can easily run 10 to 100 virtual machines and 100 to 1,000 containers on disk. Containers can be very light, a few megabits per container. No need for special storage like SAN and NAS. Docker is an open source project that automates the deployment of applications inside software containers by providing an additional layer of abstraction and automation of operating system. To conclude my presentation, here is a comparison between the connectivity technologies. In terms of short-range communication technologies, PLE has the advantage over ZigBee and NFC and others because of the high data rate and easy connect option to connect to smartphones and many other mobile devices. LoRaWAN is the choice for for an extensive coverage and very, very low power consumption and ready-made solution. Later, LTE-M and Wi-Fi IEEE 802.11ah can be the future solution. Thank you.